Yeah, my name is Robbie, R-O-B-B-I-E, Bent, B-E-N-T. I'm the COO and first employee at TrueBit. It's a scaling solution for Ethereum, allowing for off-chain verifiable computation.
That was a mouthful, but it really got to the point. Can you tell us in details, how does that work?
Yeah, so basically there's this concept of gas in Ethereum, which limits the size of or amount of transactions that can happen within a block. So if you have a really large transaction, you run into this thing. Well, one, it's not allowed, it's prevented by this gas limit, but you run into this thing called the verifiers dilemma. So imagine a super large transaction coming into Ethereum. One miner that solves this block gets a reward, but every other miner needs to verify for free. So they run into this concept of, you know, do I verify and get behind in the race, or do I just try to start mining on the next block, but then not know which block to mine on? So it ends up resulting in like some bad security preferences. So TrueBit aims to fix that. So what we allow you to do is, let's say there's a piece of code you want executed that doesn't fit within a block on Ethereum. We allow you to outsource that code to a single solver. So let's say you on your local machine. And then we allow a pool of challengers, as many as want to review the solver solution and challenge. And so now you have this thing where, instead of having to run this code on Ethereum where all the miners, you know, so let's say 70,000 nodes need to run a piece of code, there's one person solving and a handful of people that are verifying. And so as a result, it's much cheaper, and you can do much larger code off-chain and still trust the results on-chain. And so you think about it, now you have a system where you can post whatever code of any size that you want run off-chain. You have somebody solving this and getting paid for it. You have a group of challengers. Now, if these solvers, you know, both the solvers and challengers also have to put up stake. And so if the solver is caught cheating, we can slash them, right, to promote good behavior. And so now you think, well, if a solver knows that somebody's watching, they're never going to cheat. And if they never cheat, these challengers are never going to get paid. And so we then, you know, over time, the challengers will stop providing verification services. So we've introduced one of the unique parts of TrueBit is what's called the forced error. So, you know, we've at every specific random intervals, the solver will actually submit an incorrect solution, and verifiers that find this incorrect solution will win a jackpot. Very similar to how, you know, Bitcoin miners or exactly. And so you now have incentives aligned where, you know, a task issuer can run something that's too large for Ethereum and guarantee the result using Ethereum. A solver is paid to provide compute power. Challengers are paid to check over time by winning this jackpot.
So it's like all these different decentralized ways of creating an ecosystem with aligned incentives for everything to get done faster.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, and for like larger compute. So, you know, what, you know, say, what might you use this for? So there's a number of really cool use cases we're looking at now. One is with live peer, where they do video transcoding. So somebody posts, a broadcaster posts a video they'd like, transcode it. A transcoder does the work, but how do you know the transcoder's actually done what they said they're going to do? So that transcoded task gets kicked out to TrueBit. TrueBit has a solver who solves, and people who check and verify and provide the answer back to LivePeer. So that's one example of, you know, verifying video transcoding. Another example is working with Gnosis. They're doing a batch auction. A batch auction is, imagine having a decentralized exchange using batch auction. So imagine having, you know, 10 buy orders and 10 sell orders coming in at different prices, and you want to optimize those. That calculation can't be done on chain, so that could be kicked out to TrueBit. Another example might be Aragon for tabulating votes.
Right.
So imagine having, you know, a million votes on chain, iterating through that table of votes to find the result. That piece can't actually be done on chain. So just any of these use cases that, as Ethereum grows, it gets more, programs get more complex, a lot of these things can't be done on chain.
Very cool. At the Ethereum Alarm Clock that we have the partnership with Piper Miriam, we also have these incentives for time nodes to compete to execute a transaction.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it sounds like similar concept, you know, of decentralizing and aligning the incentives so that these things can happen. That's awesome. Can you think of any use cases for what I just said, you know, scheduling things for the future, using that kind of model?
Yeah, assuming you wanted to schedule something on a complex schedule, right?
Yeah.
You know, or you wanted to schedule like things in a batch.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'd have to look more into this. I'm not exactly sure how this works, but yeah. Assuming you are running contracts that don't fit within the gas limit,
right.
There'd definitely be a potential to run them off-chain and trust the results using TrueBit.
Cool. Thank you for your thoughts. Okay, cool. So how can people learn more about TrueBit?
So, I mean, they can go to our website, TrueBit.io. They can look at our GitHub. It's mm-hmm. TrueBit Foundation on GitHub. All of our code is open source.
Very cool.
We also have a TrueBit Medium, just medium.com/TrueBit, where we post things about, you know, token mechanics, applications, how TrueBit works. We built something called the Doge Ethereum Bridge. Yeah, so we built the piece going from Dogecoin to Ethereum with Oscar Ginsburg and CoinFabric. We were awarded a $200,000 bounty, of which we donated to a massive art project. So you can learn more about that on Mediums in Central Park. There's going to be a massive 45-foot climb bottle built out of aluminum with a ton of art installations inside connected to the blockchain, all from this really cool Doge Ethereum
bounty. That is
going bounty.
To bring a lot of attention to this space.
Yeah,
really
so
cool.
The idea is to get non-technical people educated and more interested in crypto, people that are interested in arts, but maybe not necessarily software development.
Nice. It's literally becoming a part of the offline community.
Yeah, exactly.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your thoughts, and you know, thank you for speaking here at the Community Conference.
Cool, no problem.